subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 12th of October. 5 terrorists neutralized in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir, Shopian. Inflation has broken common man's back, say locals in Pakistan's Lahore. And Afghan Foreign Minister wants good relations, need more time on girls' education. And now for all the details. At least 5 terrorists were neutralized by security forces in 2 separate encounters in the past 24 hours in Shopian district of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory. This came a day after 5 Indian Army soldiers were killed during counter-terrorism operations in Poonch sector of the Union Territory.
Security forces neutralized 5 terrorists in 2 separate encounters during counter-terrorism operations in Shopian district of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory in the past 24 hours. In the first encounter in Tulran area in Shopian on Monday evening, 3 terrorists belonging to the resistance force affiliated to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror outfit were neutralized. In the second encounter on Tuesday morning in Firipura area in the district, at least 2 terrorists were gunned down, the police confirmed. Kashmir Zone Police said that out of the 3 terrorists killed on Monday evening, one was identified as Mukhtar Shah, who was involved in recent civilian killings in the Kashmir Valley. Operations were still underway in the district till the last reports came in.
Gandharwal ka ek terrorist hai, recently joined kiya tha, Mukhtar. To jo ek jo Bihar ke jo Pasman ji the, jo street hawker the, उसको मारने के बाद ये साउथ कश्मीर भाग गया था तो हम लोग को खबर सीटें खबर मिला था तो उसको हम फॉलो कर रहे थे इनपुट को करते करते कल इनकाउंटर मारा गया है
Meanwhile, security forces have stepped up operations in Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir following the death of at least 5 Indian soldiers on Monday in a series of gun battles.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday took a swipe against the allegedly selective approach to human rights by people, those who view them through political lens. Speaking virtually at the 28th anniversary function of the National Human Rights Commission in capital New Delhi, PM Modi said such process undermines the cause of both democracy and human rights as well.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday said the biggest infringement of human rights occurred when seen through a political lens and warned against a selective approach of rights issues. Addressing the 28th Foundation Day of the NHRC, National Human Rights Commission, virtually, he cautioned against the selective interpretation of human rights and using human rights to diminish the image of the country.
मानव अधिकार का बहुत ज्यादा हनन तब होता है जब उसे राजनीतिक रंग से देखा जाता है राजनीतिक चश्मे से देखा जाता है राजनीतिक नफा नुकसान के तराजू से तोला जाता है इस तरह का सिलेक्टिव व्यवहार लोकतंत्र के लिए भी उतना ही नुकसानदायक है हम देखते हैं कि ऐसे ही सिलेक्टिव व्यवहार करते हुए कुछ लोग मानव अधिकारों के हनन के नाम पर देश की छवि को भी नुकसान पहुंचाने का प्रयास करते हैं
The National Human Rights Commission was established on October 12, 1993 for the promotion and protection of human rights. The body takes cognizance of any form of human rights violation, conducts inquiries, and if the violation is established, recommends various remedial and legal measures.
In news from Pakistan, residents of Pakistan's Lahore city have expressed anger over frequent price hike of food, fuel and other essential commodities in recent days, which they claim has made their survival difficult. They have blamed Prime Minister Imran Khan's government has failed to control rising inflation in the country amid economic crisis.
Locals in Pakistan's Lahore city have expressed anger over skyrocketing inflation in the country and the frequent price hike of food, fuel and other essential commodities in recent days, which they claim has made their survival difficult. They have blamed failed policies of PM Imran Khan-led government for the widening inflation in Pakistan and accused the establishment of being apathetic towards their plight while making tall claims of bringing prosperity.
ਲੱਕ ਤੋੜ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਮਹਿੰਗਾਈ ਨੇ ਫੜ ਕੇ ਕੋਈ ਚੀਜ਼ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਸਤੀ ਇਹ ਲੈਣ ਆਇਆ ਸਾਂ ਮੁਰਗੀ ਲੈਣ ਆਇਆ ਸਾਂ ਮੁਰਗੀ ਜਨਾਬ 350 ਰੁਪਈਏ ਕਿਲੋ ਵਿਕਦੀ ਪਈ ਹੈ ਕੋਈ ਪੁੱਛਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੋਈ ਦੱਸਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਨਹੀਂ
ਮਹਿੰਗਾਈ ਤਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਜਨਾਬ ਹੋ ਗਈ ਹੈ ਗਰੀਬ ਬੰਦਾ ਰਹਿ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਮੋਲ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਗੈਸ ਮਹਿੰਗੀ ਬੱਤੀ ਮਹਿੰਗੀ ਪਾਣੀ ਮਹਿੰਗੀ ਇਹ ਗੋ ਮੁਰਗੀ ਦਾ ਗੋਸ਼ਤ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਮਹਿੰਗਾ ਕੀ ਬੰਦਾ ਖਾ ਸਕਦਾ ਬਸ ਗੁਜ਼ਾਰਾ ਹੀ ਹੈਗਾ
Meanwhile, amid the rising inflation, Pakistani Minister Ali Amin Gandapur has courted controversy after he recently asked people to reduce intake of sugar and bread, according to local media reports. Opposition parties have also slammed the government over consecutive hike in prices of fuel and food items and have been holding protests across the country, demanding Prime Minister Imran Khan to step down.
Moving on. Bestowed with diverse flora and fauna and colorful lakes, Gezer Valley of Gilgit-Baltistan is a potential tourist hotspot. However, locals and tourists visiting the illegally occupied region have lamented poor road infrastructure and lack of interest by Pakistan government to promote the tourism sector has led to its decline.
A land of colorful lakes, dotted with trees and deep blue sky, Gilgit-Baltistan's Gezer district is bestowed with beautiful landscapes and is a potential tourist hotspot. But locals say the lack of infrastructure, poor roads and transport facilities and the government's failure to promote tourism continues to serve as a major hindrance for both domestic as well as international tourists.
सेहत को प्रमोट करने की बातें कर रहे हैं लेकिन अमली काम हमें कुछ नहीं दिखाई दे रहा सड़क की अगर हम बात करें तो सड़क इंतहाई खस्ता हाल है सयाहों को यहां तक पहुंचने में सख्त तरीन मुश्किलात का सामना है
Locals and tourists have also claimed that despite various efforts being taken to stop illegal fishing the famous trout fish in the region is disappearing day by day and fisheries department needs to address this issue
ये फिश इसकी डिटेल में अगर बताएं तो ये एक एंगलिंग फिश है और यहाँ पे 6 से ज़्यादा मछली आप एक दिन में नहीं पकड़ सकते लेकिन यहाँ लोग किलो किलो बल्कि मनु के हिसाब से भी मछली के गैर कानूनी शिकार में मुलविस रहे हैं इस हवाले से सख्ती करने की अशद ज़रूरत है तो कंजर्वेशन एरिया से वहाँ पर भी सख्ती करने की ज़रूरत है
Locals claim illegally occupied by Pakistan more than 6 decades ago, Gilgit-Baltistan has remained backward and underdeveloped due to the apathy of Islamabad over the years.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan's Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi, who is in Doha post a two-day meeting with US officials this week, has said the country requires a political structure that responds to domestic needs and adheres to the international norms. Speaking at an event organized by Center for Conflict and Humanitarian Studies, Doha, Muttaqi appealed to the world for good relations but avoided making firm commitments on girls' education despite international demands to allow all Afghan children to go back to school. Afghanistan's Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi appealed to the world for good relations on Monday. But avoided making firm commitments on girls' education despite international demands to allow all Afghan children to go back to school. Muttaqi was speaking at an event organized by Center for Conflict and Humanitarian Studies at the Doha Institute for Graduate Studies. Almost 2 months after the former Western-backed government collapsed and insurgent forces swept into Kabul, the new Taliban administration has pushed to build relations with other countries to help stave off a catastrophic economic crisis.
Afghanistan de musliman hewat pato gwaadi de islamin ali la dawlatuno aw milatuno sara najdi aw musbat ali ki walari Afghanistan de islamin ali de wujood wa muhima barkha da hamdar az mur la gharbi nari aw khaliji hewaduno sara hamdar az mur la arabi nari aw khaliji hewaduno sara khas ali ki gwaadu Afghanistan na gwaadi che ba bahrani o munazao ki دخل وی بلکہ موږ ټول لورو ته مثبت اړیکې غواړو.
Muttaqi said the Taliban's Islamic Emirate government was moving carefully, but had only been in power for a few weeks and could not be expected to complete reforms the international community had not been able to implement in 20 years. The new administration has come under sustained criticism for its approach to girls' education. After a decision last month that schools above the 6th grade would only reopen for boys. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres said the Taliban had broken promises on guaranteeing rights for women and girls, and there was no way the economy could be fixed if women were barred from work. Muttaqi repeated calls for the United States to lift a block on more than $9 billion of Afghan central bank reserves held outside the country, but said the government had revenues of its own from taxes, customs tariffs and agriculture if the funds remain frozen. Moving on to news from Bangladesh. A court in Bangladesh capital Dhaka has sentenced former Deputy Interior Minister Lutfuzzaman Babar to 8 years in jail in a case filed against him on charges of amassing illegal wealth and concealing wealth statement. The court on Tuesday also fined Babar Taka 10,000 failing to pay, which would result in 3 more months of imprisonment. Defence counsel will appeal to the High Court against the verdict, reports suggest. The Anti-Corruption Commission filed the case against Babar with Ramnath Police in January 13, 2008, accusing him of amassing wealth of around 7.5 crore taka illegally, that is $822,860. Babar has been in the prison after being arrested from his residence on May 28, 2007. He was sentenced to 17 years of imprisonment in an arms case on October 30, 2007. He was also sentenced to death in the 10-truck arms haul and 2004 grenade attack cases. Devotees have placed over 2,500 dolls and idols of Hindu gods and goddesses in the premises of a famous temple in southern Kerala state to mark the ongoing Navratri or Nine Nights festival. The arrangement of dolls and idols is known as Bommai Kolu and is the main attraction of the annual Navratri celebrations in southern India.
Hindu devotees in Thiruvananthapuram city of India's southern Kerala state have placed over 2,500 dolls and idols of Hindu gods and goddesses in the premises of Gandhari Amman Kovil temple to celebrate Navratri or Nine Nights festival. The arrangements of dolls and idols is known as Bommai Kolu, and it is the main attraction of the annual festival in southern India. However, amid the pandemic, the number of visitors to the famous temple has dwindled as the state is still reporting over 10,000 COVID-19 cases daily.
Ella varshavum ee reethiyulla roopangal deviyudeyum devanne roopangal ulpadeyulla vigrahangal konde alangiricha navaratri mandapathil paarayanangalum kacheriyum bhaktigana sudayum nadakkarunde. Ee pravashyathe oru pratheekatha ennu parayunnathu 2,500-olam roopangal konde devi devanmarudeyum mattumulla roopangal konde alangaricha oru mandapamaanu.
Meanwhile, as part of Bommai Kolu tradition, a resident of India's southern Bengaluru city has also put on display about 10,000 traditional festive dolls in her collection, showcasing the scenes from various Hindu religious epics and other stories. Bommai Kolu culminates on the 10th day with the celebration of the Shehra festival, and celebrations in parts of southern India are considered incomplete without the local tradition.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. 5 terrorists neutralized in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir, Shopian. Inflation has broken common man's back, say locals in Pakistan's Lahore. And Afghan foreign minister wants good relations, need more time on girls' education. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline.
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.